So public transit is something a lot of people think about and a lot of people worry about. Let me just shortcut this answer first by giving you perhaps the most meaningful statement, and that is that I took the metro to come here today. But a little more seriously, of course, anytime you're in a room, a bus, a subway car with other people, that increases your risk of being exposed to the virus. But what we're not relying on here is that you should be avoiding meeting every other human for the rest of your life to avoid getting COVID. What we're relying on are the common sense principles that we've used up until now, which is number one, vaccines. Two doses of the vaccine will protect you better than anything else out there other than locking yourself in a little box. And after that, of course, masks, which we know are up to 80% effective at preventing the transmission in face of being exposed to somebody. I guess the most important point, though, is that when we look at all of the places we've seen outbreaks, it's surprising, but public transit has not been a big source of outbreaks. Most of the outbreaks that have been described on public transit are, in fact, on long-haul trains and buses where people have been in these vehicles for up to 8 hours at a time. And I would certainly hope your commute to McGill is shorter than that.